A building is just a building. It's brick and it's steel until that building brings memories. Hi, I'm Don Preister. This is my brother Dan and my brother Ron, and this building has memories for us. It's the historic Livestock Exchange Building here in South Omaha. Today, April Fool's Day, and we're not fooling around completely because we're here to remember some of our history and remember history of the entire state that this building represents. It has a lot of memories for all of us. And I'd ask my brother Ron, who worked in the stockyards all around the building, if he'd like to start and tell us a little bit about his experiences at the stockyards. Ron?
Well, it was a pretty good job. It was interesting. Anytime you're chasing livestock and there's a chance they can chase you, there's seldom a dull moment. And I kind of feel like I was part of history being able to work here. In the 1800s, when the Livestock Exchange Building was founded, the city of South Omaha grew so rapidly. It was called a miracle city, I believe. And the people of South Omaha came from all over of Europe and various places to participate in a growing economy and a good chance for prosperity for them and their families.
And Dan, any things that you can think of about growing up or your experiences here?
I remember as a young teenager, even younger than that, when I was in my, maybe 10, 11 years old, we went to the Catholic grade school up the hill. And as we decided to venture out of the neighborhood and explore a little bit more, we would come down and a bunch of us would cross L Street and take the viaduct over and come in and kind of explore the exchange building. At that time, there was a bank in there. Packers had a little branch, and there was a little soda fountain in there too. And we would spend some time in there just looking around, seeing the different things that were in that area. We would also then come back out whenever they would kick us out of there, because we were just basically loitering. We didn't have any business to be in there, but it was just a neat place to come and see. We were kids, we were exploring things. And so then we'd head back down the viaduct and take one of the catwalks, and the catwalks were part of the livestock exchange area where they kept the animals. And above, you could walk out there and look down and see the pens and just have a way of getting around without being actually down with the animals. And so we would spend through 2-3 hours out there just walking around, seeing what we could do. Occasionally we would go down off of the catwalks and down into the pens. And once in a while, of course, we got chased out of there because, again, being kids, we were just looking for something to do. We weren't really causing any problems, but, we could have got hurt or a lot of things. That never happened, but
if you stayed on the catwalk, security wouldn't chase you out.
Exactly. You were okay there, but the minute you got down, it went a little deeper. But, we would go down there and occasionally, we would dig for fish worms. It was a great place to go and, have a place to dig whenever we needed to, because there was always fish worms there, And once in a while, we'd have somebody come by and say, what are you doing, or that kind of thing, and we'd kind of explain to them, and they were okay with it then. But it was just one of the many things that we did while we were there. So it was a great experience for me as a kid just to be able to explore.
It was a great experience for lots of people. This was a destination of hope and opportunity for people, as Ron said, from all over the world. In the late 1880s, there was nothing here but grass and prairie. There was nothing until the stockyards began to develop. And once it was founded in 1883, South Omaha City Incorporated, with 150 people, mere prairie village. 5 years later, after that incorporation, there were 8,000 people that lived in South Omaha. At that time, just a couple years later, there were 8,000 people living here, but 5,000 people already were working in the stockyards and the packing house industry. Those 5,000 people generated a $2 million a year payroll. $2 million a year back in the 1800s, incredible. It did become the Magic City. It grew so rapidly from that village of 150 people, and by the way, of that, the only retailers, 15 bars. And we remember growing up as kids, Q Street was one line of bars everywhere they could be outside of the packing houses. Over on L Street, 24th Street, all the way around, there were bars. It was a tough job. It was long, hard hours, but it paid well once it became unionized and people could make a good living and afford to have more opportunity for their families and their kids. The sheep barn was built in 1903, the first one, that held 50,000 sheep. It was almost too small from the time it was built. Only 3 years later, they had to expand it. 100,000 sheep just over here to the south of the building were housed. It was the largest sheep operation in the world. To the other side, over to the north, we had in, I believe it was the late 19 teens, about 1913 or 14, they built the largest horse and mule barn in the world. A city block square was the size of that building. It was brick and steel and a unique barn anywhere in the world. That barn had the livestock market that provided horses and mules that supplied World War II, because at that time we were still using horses and mules to pull a lot of heavy equipment. This location became a center for the world. It was the breadbasket that fed the world. Even through the 1930s, the dirty 30s, this area thrived because no matter what, people still had to eat. And once the large meat packers moved in, the area grew even more rapidly. It was the only place in the world where all of the big four packers, Wilson, Swift, Cudahy, and Armour, had packing industry plants. It was the largest horse market, it was the largest sheep market already at the turn of the century. We played in that old horse barn.
Yep.
Ron, you got any memories of doing stuff there?
Most of the memories I have of the sheep barn or maybe going through there shooting pigeons with a BB gun. And of course, when I worked here, sometimes I'd have the misfortune to have to push sheep through there. I never did think much of sheep. I found them to be pretty stupid animals. If you had 10 of them in front of you hollering at them, the front ones would just put the brakes on and the back ones would let you beat them to death before they'd try to push into the herd and go anywhere. But if you grabbed one and drug it, all the rest would follow like Pied Piper. So I guess that's the saying, follow like sheep. The horse and mule barn I have some memories of when I worked at the stockyards, because we would park hay trucks in that building at sometimes in the winter, keep them out of the elements. And it was quite a sight. Even though there was no operation going on, just the mere size of it was pretty impressive to see all the different stalls and stanchions, one thing or another.
Yeah, it was, like I said, a square block. It was over 2 acres of building, which was pretty impressive. Sheep barn was multi-storied, so they could get more sheep in smaller areas. But 100,000 sheep concentrated in one area was pretty large. They also had the markets here and sale barns, so you could buy them. They did exchange, and this building is called Livestock Exchange because the farmers brought them here. Farmers from over 20 states shipped livestock, and they came on rail, they came in truck, they came in all different ways to this location, where then somebody else purchased them and they were then taken to the various packing houses. Hogs were slaughtered here, sheep were slaughtered here, and cattle, all of those packers. In, I believe it was about the 30s, there were 50,000 head of animals slaughtered every single day at this location. Incredible amount of meat production for people all over the country and even in other countries where that food was sent to. Each of us, our uncles, our dad, all worked in the packing industry, the packing plants, and Ron, likewise, riding a horse, moving the cattle around over in the stockyards, and all grew up. Everybody who was here was looking for more opportunity. They were able to find it, I think, because they could get good paying jobs that afforded them an opportunity to send their kids to school and to be able to move into jobs that weren't quite so taxing and so difficult. So this building is just a building. It's just brick and mortar. Although it was the first million-dollar building that Peter Key would ever built, it represents history for many of us. It represents that background of our farm heritage and the farmers across not only Nebraska and Iowa, but 18 or 19 other states where people ship their livestock to. Inside that building, as Dan was saying, it had virtually everything. There was a bank, there was a cigar store, there were hotels and places to stay, restaurants, there were clothing stores. You could go in that building and look around and stay there all day. And some of the families came in and did just that while the livestock was being unloaded. It became a destination site. It was a lively, exciting time and an exciting place. And today, still, people come to South Omaha for hope and opportunity, although the industry is very different. It became decentralized, and in the heyday, when things were the largest in the world from 1955 to 1973, there were large amounts of cattle and hogs and sheep, no longer many horses or mules, that came to this center. But that decentralization started happening. The whole production system changed, and slowly it dwindled down until 1978, I believe it was, the last of the big packers closed. The stockyards folded in 1999, and only this building really remains of all of the history. Although there are symbols of it around and small parts of it, the majority is gone. But it lives on in the memories of those of us who grew up here, lived here, and continue to live here. So this building symbolizes all of that growing up, all of those times of catching pigeons or going after the rats that ran around or walking the catwalks, which were really ahead of its time. That was state of the art in the industry back at that time. Those are memories that we hold and that caused this building to mean so much more than just brick and steel. I don't know if either of you have anything else you might want to add.
I just remember as a kid, especially Sunday nights, the amount of trucks that would line up on L Street, and they would start sometimes by 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning, and by 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, the line of trucks went past, just parked out on L Street, past 42nd Street, and beyond that. Just amazing the amount of people that came to this area on a Sunday night for the Monday morning markets.
One of my fondest memories is working at the stockyards is the fact that I loved to ride horses and I got paid to do it. And the fact that occasionally cattle would try to derail me or make my day a little more exciting just kind of added to that. Just a lot of fond memories there. Somewhat growing up on a farm, it was a nice place to have to come to work every day.
So the building stands and the memories stand, and we're fortunate that we were able to save this building, because as the stockyards closed, there was an attempt to demolish the building, tear it down completely. It was largely through the efforts of South Omaha people and people across the state that an outcry arose that there would be even a consideration to destroy such a wonderful historic symbol. it's not only a symbol here, but as the other two largest stockyards in Kansas City and in Chicago were eventually totally destroyed with almost no remains, this is really the last historic remnant of anything dealing with that industry, a time of industry across this nation that rapidly saw growth. So we're proud that the building is still here. We're pleased that it's been renovated, and we want other people to understand and appreciate the value that it holds for so many thousands of people who have benefited from the industry that has been and has continued to make South Omaha a vital and an exciting place.
Amen.